Motions to follow her to her classroom.
Here in Decatur, Georgia, there's a 5-year-old girl who can't wait to get started on her day. Born with Down syndrome, Avery faces some big challenges when it comes to getting by in school.
Mom, Sherry Copenhaver.
What we want to focus on are basic life skills. And of course, the most important of those is reading.
That's why her mom was so excited to find the Coralwood School, a public preschool program that's helped Avery develop her language skills, an important precursor to reading.
Mommy!
Yes, ma'am!
Coralwood's inclusion model means that children with special needs like Avery learn alongside typically developing kids like her friend Caroline.
Principal Blanton.
The program originally began for students with special needs, but in about 1990 we realized that for the children to learn from other children we needed some typically developing students in the buildings, and it has worked great because both sets benefit from it.
For Avery, this environment means that she gets to spend every day working with other students who can model those skills that are sticking points for her.
Dr. Newman.
The special needs child in the very early years benefits tremendously from being in these classrooms. They develop friendships. They see how other children work. They learn to adapt and accept their own disability, and they learn to have peers who help them in certain ways.
Lisa Nasser, Avery's special education teacher, remembers her first day working with Avery.
Avery came to us this year almost nonverbal. She depended on sign language and she was an observer.
My biggest goal for her was speech. I want her to talk in full sentences, and she's finally starting to do that. Now there are like maybe 3 or 4 word sentences, but she's made huge strides. We've gone from sign language to 3 and 4 word sentences, so I'm thrilled with that.
Avery speaking. Jennifer Mazarki.
Just in the last few months, Avery has shown amazing progress. At the beginning of the year, she might say yes, no, hi, bye. Now, she told one of the other teachers, my lips are chapped. You could tell she understood what that meant. She knew what that meant. And that's another big part of language, is not only being able to say it, but to understand what you're saying and what it means.
When it's time for Avery to learn to read, she'll need intensive one-on-one help. But the steps she's taking in class right now are critical. And while Coralwood's dedicated staff plays a large part in this progress, they're the first to recognize that Avery has some other helpers too.
Susan Garrett.
Children provide as much stimulation and modeling as teachers and therapists do.
This modeling is something that speech-language pathologist Susan Garrett sees every day. And it's one of the main reasons that Coralwood provides almost all of its therapies in the classroom.
Susan Garrett.
When we were doing the napping story and we were emphasizing that Avery wasn't interested in looking at me, but she was interested in looking at Caroline.
Miss Avery, can I hear you? Let's look at Caroline.
So while Avery has a long road ahead to become a reader, Coralwood is giving her a good start. And it all began with a bus ride.
Sherry.
When I put her on the bus for the first time, and she was 3, and I pinned a note to her that said, my name's Avery Copenhaver, please make sure I get to Sylvia Goggins' class. And I was a wreck. She was fine. You know, she thought it was an adventure.
What's R? Beautiful. And what does it say all together? What is this? This is your name. What does it say? Avery. It does say A.